here in downtown Mansfield, Ohio, inside of the Tritico building, right here in the brand new OH Report studio. We are in person with none other than professional featherweight boxer Chaise Nelson, born and raised right here in the city. And you got some momentum rolling right now, my man. Five consecutive wins coming off of a W earlier in this month. I imagine you got to be feel like you're riding high right now for your career at age 21.
I feel like where I'm at, where I should be. I think I should be like five fights ahead right now. So basically, the goal right now is to fight as much as we can to get to where we want to be. We're talking about going down to 122 to get a title shot faster. I just got a text this morning actually about July 6th in Toledo, Ohio.
Okay.
So they're going to keep me really busy because I kind of talked with them about that. And so that's the plan. I want at least five, six more fights within the next year and a half.
I know your fans here in the Buckeye State would appreciate it if you could fight here locally in Toledo, especially.
And that's something that I'm trying to work on too, actually, is to get somebody here in Mansfield as well. I think that would just be great for us. So.
All right, so five consecutive wins, like I mentioned, all by unanimous decision, which is good, but no KOs, man. Is that anything that you think about? Does that bother you? Are you cool just getting the W?
I mean, I don't rush things like that because that's how you get caught. So going the full distance, I think you learn a lot more than you would if you knock someone out in the first round. But my last fight, I dropped him in the first round, cut him, and then I dropped him in the last round too. He just ran from me, man. So a lot of people aren't in there to win, they're in there to survive. And those are the guys that are hard to knock out.
You had mentioned that you wish you were probably about five fights ahead of where you wanted to be. And the road to get where you're at right now obviously hasn't been easy since you turned pro. You had the 16-month layoff. You had guys not show up at weigh-ins when you got your first title shot. You've had people duck you in the past as well. What would you say is the top lesson that you've learned about being a professional fighter that's really stuck out to you?
Just trust your process. You know, be patient. Things will come. I'm a true believer in, like, everything happens for a reason. So if it didn't happen, then it wasn't supposed to happen. So I just try to stay focused, keep a good mindset and just, you know, keep going down the path I am. I mean, I know people that know that I broke my hand not even too long ago. I was still in the gym. I don't have a fight date. I'm still in the gym. I'm still staying prepared in case something does come up. So I'm just always in the gym working, and I'm just really trying to stay focused on, like, what I'm doing in my craft.
I want you to elaborate a little bit more on that. Tell me the difference between training just to stay ready for any phone call that you might get versus when you know you have an opponent and it's getting ready for that.
So, like, for example, when I know I have somebody, I'm working on certain moves, angles, punches. I'm doing certain things, and I'm doing them over and over and over again just because whatever works best is what you want to do. So you want to be the best prepared you can be. Now, when I'm just, like, training and, like, you know, with my friends or, like, just going in the gym, I'm just doing things like to stay in shape so I don't get tired fast or you know, I don't get fat, you know, so just stuff like that. But so there's like a little bit, it's not a big difference, but for example, like me and my dad, we work on certain things just for my opponent rather than if I don't have nobody that's in front of me, I'm just working on things just to stay in shape.
I know that you're pretty much a guy that always has a positive mindset and your outlook's usually pretty awesome. But there was a time there, like I said, with the 16-month layoff where just things just didn't seem like they were going your way. Did you ever contemplate, maybe this isn't for me, step away or give it up altogether?
It was definitely hard for me. You know, I have been there a few times, but I feel like this is where I belong. You know, I feel like when I'm in there, I feel free. You know, I feel like I'm right where I should be. And I think a lot of people are starting to realize, like, okay, like, this kid's serious, you know? Like, I'm starting to build a fan base even down in Texas. So people that don't even know me are starting to come up to me and ask about me and things like that. You know, it's definitely been hard, but I think I'm right where I should be. So I'm just gonna continue and try to get that big shot.
You're obviously a confident kid and you're never really scared to talk about that. Do you think that being humble actually matters in your sport? Because to me, when I watch the TV and then the big fights, it seems like the dudes that have the bravado and the big egos tend to get on those big cards and actually are some of the best boxers that I've seen.
I mean, those guys sell out cards, but to me, it's important to me because I've been through so much in life, man. Like, since I became pro, before pro, all that. So I've been through so much in life at such a young age and have seen so much and I've been through so much that's why I'm humble. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not going to be cocky. I'm not going to blow people off. I'm not going to act like, you know, I'm better than other people. I'm just myself, you know, and that's how I always want to be. And I feel like if that's how you act and that's how people see you as, the right people are going to be around you, which is important to me, you know. So I don't really care for that cocky stuff. I'm just myself, you know.
Who's some of your favorites right now in the fight game? Who do you enjoy turning on and watching?
Canelo Alvarez, Terrence Crawford, Javante Davis. He's a beast. I don't like Deontay Wilder, but he knocks people out, so he's fun to watch. Vasily Lomachenko, guys like that.
I've heard debate on both sides of this argument. Some in the boxing game will say because you only have two weapons to fire with that it takes a little bit more skill set than it would for a mixed martial artist who you have to worry about the knees, elbows, takedowns, all that. In your personal opinion, if you can be objective about this, what actually takes more skill, mixed martial arts or boxing?
Obviously, mixed martial arts you have to be concerned about more, so you have to work on more things. But I mean, when it comes to skill-wise, like anybody can be in mixed martial arts and be average, just like anybody can be in, you know, boxing and be average. So it really depends on like discipline and how good you really are. But yeah, I mean, of course, if you're fighting someone that like boxes, you just gotta worry about hands. But if you're fighting someone that like can take you down and choke you out and knee you in the face, I mean, that's, you know, that's a little bit more. So it just depends on who you talk to. I've heard people say it's been mixed martial arts. I've heard people say it's been boxing. So I don't know. I would say, I guess, mixed martial arts, just because you have more to like be concerned about.
How often do you actually get a chance to lift weights? Because I know that you have to, when you fight, you're at like 123, 124 pounds. Is that something that you can even include in your training methods?
Well, actually, recently, I've kind of been like stressed out with just stuff going on in like my personal life. So I've been starting to like lift weights a lot more. And I mean, it makes me feel good, you know? I don't feel any slower, because that was like the main thing that my team was concerned with. Like, we don't want you to like lift all these weights and like you like slow down, because like I'm known for my hand speed, and I don't feel slower, I don't look slower. So I just do it for fun, like with my friends and stuff, and it's a good way to like get some steam off. So I like it. I mean, I've been doing it probably 3 times a week now.
You have told me on many occasions that cutting weight easily to you is the worst part about being a professional boxer, that it's not close. So for somebody out there, maybe some kid that's watching that's like, man, I might just want to go after being a pro boxer, tell them a horror story. Like, what's something that you've went through for your weight cut when you had to make a specific weight?
Okay, so anybody that knows me or has been around me when I've cut weight, like, I'm a complete a-hole, man. Like, I'm just cranky. Like, I mean, it's horrible, but... Okay, so a couple fights ago, actually, I had to make weight on the day of weigh-ins because their scale was off. Our scale was on, their scale was off. But regardless, they were going to make me cut down that weight, and I had like a pound to go. So we took a hot bath, and a hot bath is, you fill the tub up with hot as you can take it, get in there with sweats and a sweatshirt on, with a hood on, and you'll lose like a pound in like 5-10 minutes, but it dehydrates and you can pass out. So we had to do that morning because we only had like an hour until weigh-ins. And I got out of the tub and took off my clothes and stuff. And I was so weak that I couldn't even put on my shirt. Like my dad had to like put on my shirt for me.
Wow.
And then he had to like help me walk down the hallway. And when I got to like the weigh-in room, like I had to act strong. Like the doctor checks you out and stuff. And like I literally felt like I was going to pass out. Like, I could hardly even hold myself up on the chair. Well, that's mostly my problem, too, because I like to eat pizza, chicken wings, you know what I'm saying, like ice cream. Like, I don't have a strict diet like I should. So I kind of put that on myself sometimes. But yeah, that weight cut is no joke. So if you're not used to it, it can drive you crazy, seriously.
So let's say that I'm just going to be a good pal to you right now. I got a magic elixir and I can just throw it on any one food for you. And no matter how much of it you eat, you're not going to gain weight. Matter of fact, you're going to get stronger and better looking every single time you consume this. What's the one food that you would pick?
Like anything that I want?
Anything.
Cheesecake.
Cheesecake. Just nonstop eating cheesecake.
I love cheesecake. Yeah, cheesecake. I love cheesecake.
All right, man. Let's get to know a few more of your likes here. We're going to do a quick round of either or.
Do it.
Pastries or cookies?
Pastries.
Gum or breath mints?
Gum.
Iced or hot coffee?
Iced.
Comedy movies or thrillers?
Thrillers.
Night in or night out?
Depends on the night, but I'm usually like a night in type guy.
Dress clothes or casual?
Casual.
Country life or city life?
Country.
Football or basketball?
Football.
Would you say that you're a better football player than basketball player?
Yeah, definitely.
Night owl or early riser?
Night owl.
More scared to fight in their prime, Mike Tyson or Muhammad Ali?
Mike Tyson.
No doubt, huh?
Yeah.
Do you think you could last 3 rounds with the champ back then? With that guy?
I mean, at 126 pounds, nah.
It'd be tough,
nah,
huh?
Yeah, it'd be pretty tough. Yeah, I don't think so.
All right, guys, that's Chaise Nelson in person. Follow him, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. He's all over the place. Up and coming through the ranks right here in Mansfield, Ohio.